guys, it's Bobby here, and I'm back at you with another video. So today we're going to be doing a cute little summer outfit. I'm here in Texas, and it's going to be summer way into fall here, so you can still get away with a little cute short set, even though we have nowhere to go. What's up for my daily trips to the post office, Walmart, etc. So for this month, we are going to be creating a top for the jean bandana hybrid shorts that I did. If you look at my last top where I did the chili pepper outfit with the bandanas, I used the same kind of method as far as making three other panels of the shorts with the existing pattern. This time, instead of using the back, I used the front of those shorts. So if you have any questions below, you can either comment down below or go back to that video and comment the questions there. Okay, guys, so the top that I'm envisioning is gonna be nice and casual. It's gonna be a crop top, but half of it will be mesh because these bandanas do not stretch and I don't want to put a zipper in it. I'm trying to see if I can get away by incorporating skin tone and close mesh. So all of this, even this little square, will be bandana. And then this part of the shirt, that's my daughter's blocks. And this part of this sleeve will be mesh, followed by this little part being bandana. And the same will replicate in the back. So let's see if we can do this. My bandana is here on a fold. My shirt is here on a fold. It's nice and flat. And I transfer the shirt on top. And flatten her out. Now, I don't want to just go ahead and cut it. I want to make sure that this is 1/4 of my bust and waist measurement. So just go ahead and grab your measurement tape. Confirm your measurements for your bust. And confirm your measurements for your waist and divide it by 4. So my waist is 27. I just know I'm gonna go ahead and do 28, which is 7 as 1/4. It's easier for math. And this is lining up right where I need it to, which is my shirt. And my bust is 32, so 8 would be ideal for where I wanna cut that. I'm just folding it so I can cut two pieces of this. This piece is going to be used to make the front a hybrid bandana slash mesh top. So you have to fight with the mesh a little bit to get it to cooperate. But it's easier if you work with it in a smaller piece. So I'm just going ahead and cutting it a little bit more than the length that I need. Just so I can. So I can cut the front and the back together. Nice. So I'm going to take my top back and now I'm going to transfer this piece over. Cut the same shape but not with any extra seam allowance. It's already included in the yellow piece. One mesh layer and one bandana so it stays together while cutting. It doesn't have to be excessive, just a few so it stays lined up. So, putting it on my mannequin
actually on my mannequin, so I'm going to go ahead and just cut it a little bit. That's a little better. And I'm going to go ahead and just put a few stabilizing pins in through the fabric. From one shoulder, come across, and come right kind of to the armpit. Don't want it to go too low. I want all of my girls to be covered. So you can, you know, use chalk or pencil, something that can wipe away to trace your line. But we thugs over here, so we're just gonna go ahead and cut. So don't throw this away. So now these two fit like a puzzle. Sit down, you sit down, you sit down, you sit down, you sit down, you. So to connect these. As well as I did that to like the front cool piece.
Like the cool blue light.
Like the cool blue light. Even though the back is going to be stretchy. So you place your front piece on your mannequin with the right side facing the mannequin. And put in a few stabilizing pins here so it doesn't shift. So I like to find the dead center of the shirt and pin it there so it doesn't shift. And then I like to take the sides and we'll make sure it lines up straight with the center and place a pin. So you'll notice it forms extra fabric right here that needs to be folded away. So there's like some extra fabric here that forms naturally, so I'm going to grab it so it forms a dart on its own, the most natural form. So by pinching it, it forms like an angle to take the excess fabric out the sides. It right there, and we're gonna do the same thing over here. All right, so you'll notice it fits a lot more naturally to the curve of the bust and body. So we're gonna go ahead and sew these two darts at an angle before we attach it to the back of the shirt. And you do that just by laying the like sides together. So you're going to sew the two shoulder seams and sew the two side seams as well. And then I'm going to be adding some sleeves as well. But for the neckline, I think I'm going to leave this part raw so it sits and blend into my skin. But for the part that's bandana, I am going to hem that part, if that makes sense, so it's not raw. Alright guys, so now we're going to work on the sleeves for our top. So back to the shirt that we were using as a guide. Go ahead and fold it back in half. And this time you want to make sure that the sleeves are nice and flat to my bandana scraps. This one's big enough. Fold that and fold. My fold is here. I'm going to take my sleeve, and this is the fold that I'm going to line up. So you want to make sure that this is wide enough for your bicep. This is 12 inches, so this needs to be at minimum 6 inches wide. But and give yourself seam allowance so you have breathing room. Decided to cut two in bandana, just so I can use as much as this bandana scraps as possible and save my mesh fabric for another project. So this little part here, and then we'll attach it to the top. So I've gone ahead and just sewn this part of the sleeve. That's the part that's going to be underneath your arm once it's attached. So I'm now going to go ahead and attach both to the sleeves. Alright guys, here she is. I went ahead and made a face mask. But here is the shirt. And I love the bag. I'm